You unlock this door with the key of imagination. Beyond it is another dimension. A dimension of sound. A dimension of sight. A dimension of mind. You're moving into a land of both shadow and substance, of things and ideas. You've just crossed over into the Twilight Zone.
Timmy, did you buy your soup bone?
You wait for me. There's your answer. He cries at the mention of soup bone. Nothing less than T-bone for that spoiled pooch.
Smart dog.
Good morning, Mrs. Thompson.
Oh, Mr. Grover. How'd you know that was me?
How?
Yes.
It's simple. I heard you talk outside to the policeman.
Oh. What's the matter? You afraid the building's gonna fall apart?
No, the house is well built.
I'll say it is. Those girders could hold up the Empire State Building. Well, so long.
Hi, Tits.
Timmy, come in?
Yeah, he's here someplace.
You were a bad boy. Shame on you. You should have waited for me. Rick, what do you think of that janitor?
Just had a funny idea for a cartoon. I want to get it off the board.
I don't like the way he's always sneaking around, tightening things.
Hey, Ruth, come on over here. This'll kill you. These two cops are standing by a wash basin full of water. There's a straw hat on the water. Near the basin of water is a neat pile of men's clothes with a note pin on it. The one cop looks at the note and the floating straw hat and says, "Plain case of suicide." You like it?
There's a body in the basin?
Now, would it be funny if there was a body in the basin? Of course there's no body, just a floating straw hat. Those go in the kitchen.
Rick, I'm serious. This guy's a creep.
Oh, honey, what can the poor guy do about his face? He's stuck with it. Give him a break.
Will you stop kidding and listen to me?
I am.
Well, then turn around and look at me and stop treating me like I'm a child.
You're no child.
All right. You'll be sorry. Just wait till he comes in some night with an axe and dismembers us.
Oh, honey, he's just a poor guy trying to earn a living. He mops the hall, stokes the furnace.
We have electric heat and he tightens bolts.
If we had a furnace, he'd stoke it. Oh, honey, let's face it. He labors like ourselves. I draw cartoons and he mops the halls. Who can say which is the greater act?
You'll be sorry. Your canned corn's down 3 cents.
That should make me sorry.
I mean, you can't face facts.
Which are?
That man's up to something, Rick. He's no janitor.
You think maybe he's a front for a gambling syndicate? Or maybe a baby farm?
I didn't think of it. Oh. Be funny. Go ahead and be funny. Don't say I didn't warn you. Just go ahead and be superior.
Oh, honey, I am sorry. All right, I'll listen to you. What's he do that upsets you?
He doesn't do anything.
Is it the way he looks at you?
It's the way he doesn't look at me. Yet I feel like he's always watching me. I tell you, Rick, there's something funny going on around here. This man has plans.
For you.
Most of us, on waking in the morning, know exactly where we are. The rooster or the alarm clock brings us out of sleep into the familiar sights, sounds, aromas of home, and the comfort of a routine day ahead. Not so with our young friends. This will be a day like none they've ever spent, and they'll spend it in the Twilight Zone.
Anybody want some more coffee? I'll go get it.
No, thanks.
Oh, hello, Mr. Grover. Come on in.
Thank you. Good evening.
Good evening. Hello.
Well, that's fine. I see you're through with dinner. That's what I wanted to make sure.
Why?
I have to turn off the power. I wanted to make sure that everybody was through eating.
You mean no lights?
Oh, it's the 220 line. Won't affect the lights to 220. I like that painting. It's beautiful.
Sure, go right ahead. We will need the stove.
It'll only be a few minutes. Minor repairs. so long.
What was that all about?
He's got to fix the 220 volt line, repair it or something. I don't know.
There's something funny about that man.
See?
Say, when did you two kids find time to rehearse this sister act?
What sister act? It isn't a sister act. Marge feels the same way I do about Grover, and so do a lot of other wives in this building.
You've been getting this pitch, too? Grover's gonna murder us in our beds. Ruth told me. Maybe that's what he's gonna do with the 220 volt line. Wire the bed springs.
2,000 volts wouldn't even wake you. You know, there's something fishy about this entire apartment building, if you ask me. I feel the same way.
Hey, Rick, I had a good idea for a cartoon, only I can't remember it now.
Think, boy, think.
Yeah, let me see. Yeah, that's a funny idea. Straw hat floating in a wash basin. Cop says, plain case, suicide.
I'm glad you like it. Only Ruth thinks there should be a body in the basin.
There must be a fluke somewhere. $65 a month for a five-room furnished apartment. Utilities included, and all the best equipment. Now, does that make sense?
No, it doesn't.
Girls, let's not quibble. If the landlord doesn't know about the high cost of living, let's take advantage of it and be content, huh?
You, if someone offered you $1 million and said keep it, you'd take it and ask no questions.
Honey, I'd take it and run like the devil.
You're naive.
What the devil was that?
Grover's using an electric drill, sounds like.
It didn't sound anything like an electric drill.
It didn't sound like anything I ever heard.
It sounded just like when they test an electric chair in the movies. That's what it sounded like. And the lights dimmed. Well, Mr. Smart Aleck?
Yeah, maybe Grover's got an electric chair in the basement. A man needs a hobby.
Oh. I'll help with the dishes, Marge.
Rick, think about it a minute, huh?
Oh, no, not you two.
Now, wait a minute, Rick. Think about it. The rent we pay for what we get.
So we got a bargain. The landlord wants to help worthy young married couples get a start in life.
Well, there's another thing. Only young couples.
I wish you could remember the idea you had for that cartoon.
Oh, Rick, wait a minute. Look, remember the lineup when they first put these apartments on the market? You must have thought like Marge and I did. The price had to be a come-on. Well, maybe one attic apartment, $65, but it wasn't.
$65 and you moved in.
If you were both under 30 and could provide a doctor's certificate, you were perfect physical specimens.
Well, I sure fooled them. I didn't tell them about the dead spot in my brain. Cute, isn't it? Thanks. I tell you, Johnson, that wife of mine suspects the worst.
You mark my words, Thompson. There's something peculiar about every building on this block.
I'm not kidding. She's suspicious of everything. The new buildings, the low rent, the busy little janitor, especially the busy little janitor.
You mean Grover?
Yeah, she thinks it all adds up to dirty work at the crossroads.
It's my unwilling conclusion that behind those walls, six-year-olds are being forced to weave baskets by candlelight.
Say, last night there was a strange noise. Did you hear it?
I watched them put up these buildings. Should have seen the steel girders and the concrete blocks. Maybe the steel hums.
Yeah. Well, maybe Grover was waxing the floors.
Don't tell anybody. I want to break this case myself. Aside from that, how's the missus?
Well, like I said, suspicious.
Nothing specific, huh? Mm-hmm. Just the noises, low rent, and Grover.
That's about it. And don't you tell anyone. I don't want to lose a good thing.
Why don't you watch what you're doing with your tools?
I'll take it up there. Hey, feel the weight of that.
Hey, that's light, isn't it? Maybe it's for the loose nut in his head. Well, take care of yourself, Thompson. Maybe the missus got something with that globe.
Thank you very much for bringing me back my rent.
Oh, don't mention it.
I appreciate it. You know, the policeman, he looked so mad, I think he could have hit me with it over the head.
What the devil is that? A television antenna?
Yes. It's a multiple type. It's supposed to serve all apartments. Of course, to be perfectly frank, I don't know how well it'll work.
You sure got it anchored?
Oh, yes, solid. I like everything that's solid.
Hey, I've never seen anything like this before.
Well, that was put in 2 days ago.
What is it?
Oh, just a new accessory to the exhaust for the air conditioning.
The The owner sure don't spare any expense on this joint, do they?
Tell me, Mr. Thompson, Dean. The policeman, was he very mad? Certainly terribly careless of me.
Well, that wrench could have flattened him. Or me.
Yes, sir. I know I apologize.
I know how I'm done. Say, you haven't seen Mrs. Thompson or Timmy in the last couple of hours, have you?
No. Maybe they're over at the Nelsons.
Maybe.
You know, I don't think Mrs. Thompson likes me very much.
Oh, Mr. Grover, women are curious characters. They like to keep a little drama going in their lives. But it doesn't mean she doesn't like you, believe me.
It's very nice of you to say that, Mr. Thompson.
Well, so long.
So long.
Rick, where are you? Rick?
Hi, honey.
What are you doing down there?
I just got an idea for a cartoon.
Come out of there. I want to talk to you.
Now what?
I knew it. I just knew it.
You knew what?
This place is a fluke.
Oh.
Now, don't say anything. Just listen to me.
Yes, dear.
I found engines in the basement.
Engines? What kind of engines? Air conditioners or fire engines?
Don't joke about this. I tell you, I saw the things.
Oh, honey, I've been down there. How come I've never seen any engines?
You've never been down where I was.
And what were you doing down there?
Looking for Timmy. He's gone. Don't you understand? He's gone. Vanished.
There's Johnson. Maybe he's seen Timmy. I'll go ask him.
I already asked him. He hasn't seen him.
Did you tell him about the engines in the basement?
That was before.
Are you sure you really saw him?
Just a glimpse, but they were there. I ran into Grover in the basement corridor, and I was just about to ask him about Timmy, but before I could reach him, he opened this door. A big steel door.
Maybe it's fire regulations if it's a furnace room.
Don't say furnace again. I know what a furnace is.
All right, do you want me to go look for Timmy or at the engines?
It's no use looking for Timmy. He's gone.
Then it's the engines.
When you see them, you'll call the police.
Say, wait a minute. Won't Grover object to my seeing him if they're illegal?
I didn't think about that. I'll tell you what. We'll wait till tonight when he's asleep.
Good. You got a date. In the meantime, I'll phone in a lost dog ad and get that cartoon off the board.
Good, good.
Timmy's probably just down the street missing that pretty poodle. I'll get him in the morning.
It isn't, Timmy. It's 2 o'clock in the morning. You promised you'd go down and see the engines with me.
No?
Yes, yes, you promised.
Okay, okay. I'll be right there, honey.
Thompson, tell me, is it rather late for you to be up? Still looking for your dog?
Yes,
I've been looking for him all over. Maybe he's on the roof. I'll go up there right now.
Thank you.
Yeah.
You know the janitor?
Yeah.
He has three eyes.
Sure he is.
I tell you, I saw it. I ran into him in the corridor, and his hair was parted in the back, and he looked right at me with a third eye. It's in the back of his head, honey.
Good for him.
All right. All right, sleep. Go ahead, sleep. Never mind about men with three eyes. Just say your wife's crazy, that's all. Sleep. I'll go down and see about those engines myself. Kruger was going to be upstairs.
What was that? Ruth! Three eyes.
Doing down here? I've been upstairs. Oh, never mind. I'm so glad to see.
Now let's go look at those engines.
Yeah. It's here.
Here, but that's a solid wall.
Yes, but that's where Gruber went in.
What?
I tell you, I saw him do it. He went like this. Well, now, Mr. Simple Trusting Soul, do you still say there's nothing funny about this place? I suppose you're going to tell me you've seen engines like this before.
I've seen similar. I think I saw this contraption on the roof. But there must be some logical explanation.
How can you be so blasé about this, and with everything hidden behind a secret door?
I'm not being blasé. I'm just not jumping to a lot of silly conclusions like some people I know.
Well, silly or not, I still say it's a power plant for a rocket ship.
Rocket ships?
Or a plot to blow up the whole town, and we're going to go call the police.
You're going upstairs with Marge and Phil.
And call the police.
Yeah, you go upstairs and call the police. Please go.
Are you going to come with me?
In a minute. Would you please go?
Be careful.
Yeah.
Don't touch it or you'll be hurt. You'll be hurt very badly, and if you would have touched that switch, you would be dead.
What's going on here, Grover?
Sorry you discovered it's a little too early. Just a few days later, it would have been much better.
Don't give me any of that double talk. You got my wife scared to death.
I didn't mean to.
First it's these engines here. Then she thinks you're not human, you got three eyes.
Mr. Thompson, go upstairs where you belong, with your wife.
Ah!
not until... Ruth is right. Is she right about these engines, too? That this whole building is a spaceship?
No, she's not right. This is not what you call a rocket ship, but believe me, the whole building is well equipped to travel through space.
You're crazy, Grover. You're a three-eyed freak that's escaped from an insane asylum or a freak show. You're crazy. How can this building go up in the air if it's not a rocket ship?
How? Very simple. It's magnetic power that's stronger than your gravity. And this power will be supplied by another planet. Our planet.
What are you talking about?
Come on.
What are you talking about?
There is no need for violence, you hear? None! Look, you. All of you are a part of a very interesting experiment in colonization in your natural surroundings. And you won't be hurt. Unless you hurt yourself. I promise you that.
Disbelieved. However, if either of these two entities walk onto your premises, you better check the color of their eyes, all three of them. The gentleman in question might try to pull you into the Twilight Zone.